My name is Langston Wiggins, and in this video, I will go through and explain the most important things regarding money that people who have the responsibility of having money should know. I will be talking about things like credit and debit cards, the importance of your credit score, what's a ARA, etc., etc. The first thing I will be talking about is a budget. Having a budget helps you figure out where your money should go and how much you should spend at a time or how much you should spend at certain places. Having a budget will make it easier to meet your financial goals, and you'll figure out how to spend your money smarter as well. Second on the list is savings. Saving money is important because it helps you in different events, for example, like an event of a financial emergency. If you start early and set aside money that you get and don't need to spend right away, you'll have something to fall back on just in case you need it if something unexpected happens. You can put the money that you want to save in many ways, like a checking or savings account. Another thing that's important concerning money is an ARA. An IRA is another option you can take with saving your money in a later date. An IRA is an individual retirement account. It's an account that allows you to save money for retirement with tax-free growth. With this, one of the many benefits of having this is you'll give less of your savings back to the government during retirement. The next thing I will mention, and I think that's very important towards knowing money, is your credit score. Your credit score is usually based on how late your payments are, how much you might owe, and how recently and how often you missed a payment. A good credit score usually ranges from 670 to 739. 740 to 799 are considered very good, and 800 and up are considered excellent. You can have and keep a good credit score in many ways like this. Number 1. You have to pay your loans on time, every time that they're due. Number 2, a long credit history will help your score. Number 3, only apply for credit that you need. And number 4, fact check your credit reports. With a good credit score, you get various benefits like these. Number 1, low interest rates on credit scores and loans. Number 2, easier approvals for rental houses and apartments. Number 3, more negotiating power. Number 4, you can qualify for higher credit limits and loan amounts. And number 5, it opens up more credit card options. The next thing on the list is credit cards. A credit card is a physical card that can be used to make purchases, pay bills, or you can withdraw cash. The good thing about credit cards are, number 1, they can help you build good credit. Number 2, there are laws that protect you when you're using these credit cards. Number 3, they can help you rebuild any damaged credit that you have. And number 4, you can get various rewards when using credit cards. But there are also bad effects that can happen when you do have credit cards. Like, number 1, they can damage your credit score. For by example, late purchases made on any credit cards can damage your credit score. Number 2, they come with numerous fees. Number 3, they charge huge interest rates. And the interest rate is basically a portion charged to you, which means that a low rate is good, a high rate means more money you have to pay. And number 4, they encourage you to spend more money than you have, which if you spend money that you don't have and you can't pay later, that means your credit score will go down even more.